they're going to work on a fun project, which is actually a little photo holder, but it has multiple purposes. I know that June is a real popular time and summer is a real popular time for weddings. So I thought, how cool would that be to make your own little wedding, you know, table things that you can say what number the table is. You could add a little photo of the bride and groom. There's so many things you can do with these. These can be place settings. They can be photo holders. If you're having a birthday party, you could put a little thing that says happy birthday. You can really customize it to any kind of thing that you want. Or it can be a simple photo holder. So that's what's so cool about them. And all you really need are these little wire things. But you know what? You can actually make your own too. So if you have some wire and you want to make your own, I've seen people do that. And I've actually done it myself. So it's definitely a possibility. But if you don't feel like doing it, David Tutera is the one that makes it. And I'll look for a link online to Amazon or whatever where you can find them. So you just need one. If you're going to do something bigger, obviously you can use multiple ones of these. It's totally up to you. You're going to need some scrap clay. And I'm using some cutters today. And originally I had made this one. And let me just explain to you how I did it. I took a piece of scrap clay and I placed a color of clay over it. I think I used bronze on this one. And then I added these little cutters, these cutout pieces that I made using my different cutters here. And these are the mini cutters. They're new in the shop at polymerclaytv.com if you want to check them out. And this is actually a product that we'll be carrying, so I'll probably put a pre-order in there. But they come two in a set, and they're texture plates. And it's like a flexible plastic. I don't even know how to explain this plastic. It's recycled plastics, which is really cool, but they come with these different designs, and they come two to a set. So anyways, I use this one, and I just went ahead and stamped onto a plain sheet of clay and then cut them out with the cutter. So that's how I made that, and I've added these ones on the bottom. As you can see on the bottom, it was complete scrap clay. So it's a great way to use up your scrap and make something really cute. So I left that open so you could see. I poked this through. I'll add a bottom to this, obviously, but I wanted you to be able to see. So really simple to do, really cute. I have the scrap white clay, which white clay and me do not go well together. I always get it dirty or cat hair or whatever. And I'm going to do something a little different for this one. This one was a round shape, but I was thinking, if you're going to make something that's wedding themed or, you know, something like that, you're going to want a heart, aren't you? So I created the round ball, and I'm just trying to flatten this a little. Actually, I'm going to place this pink color, and that's actually two pieces of pink that I had that I pieced together to make this color. And I'm just going to piece it around. I'm not going to cover the bottom because, like I said, I'll probably do something different on the bottom. But you want to make sure you don't get any air pockets like I was just getting right there. So just wrap it around and then cut off any extra with your blade. I have some little hearts cut out already. My cutters, so let me get these off my blade here. But those are some of the hearts that I cut out of using the little cutters. So then just cut off any extra or pull it off, whatever works for you, and set that aside. You can use that to make your hearts. So then you're just going to continue to wrap it around your scrap clay like so, and then you want to kind of give it a little roll so that you smooth it out. Okay, so here you're looking at that, and if you see any air bubbles, poke them out at this point. You do not want any air pockets, and I just use my poker and then smooth it back down. Simple, simple. Okay, so now I have this shape, which is really what I want to go for is a heart now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the end of a paintbrush, and you can use any paintbrush you want, and I'm going to start to poke in the middle because a heart has like a little, you know, a little separation there at the top. And so when I get it to about what I like, then I'm going to pinch the bottom. And just keep pinching, and the idea is really to do what you like. So in the shape of the heart, you know, there's so many different shapes of hearts that you can use. You do need to use a lot of scrap clay for this. Like, I don't know, this is probably less than a bar, though. Yeah, it is less than a bar. So if you have scrap clay, this really is a good way to use it. And I'm just shaping the heart myself here. And if you want to flatten it out, use your roller. You can use your blade to help shape it, like to push in the ends, like so. Blade's a good tool. And just shape it the way you want it, exactly the way you want it before you go doing any other decorative things to it, because once you start adding pieces on, they're hard to get off. And so it's easier just to get your shape first. If you have to go back and use your paintbrush, do that. And there you have it, a simple heart shape that, as you can see, it took seconds to make. Now, there's so many different things you could do with this. You could silk screen on here. You could texture it. Really, anything you want, and the sky's the limit. So let me just see here. I should be using some release because it is warm, but I'm going to just show you so you can see what it would look like. Oh, didn't get it green. Let me roll this over gently because I'm not trying to distort it. I pull it up. So there you have a really cute design. I overlapped it when I pulled it up a little, but you get the idea. So there you have a heart shape with some texture. So you can use any rubber stamp. It doesn't have to be these. Anything will work. If you have one that's all hearts or whatever, you could totally do that. So then you want to place your photo holder or whatever it is down in the middle. So you just look for the middle. And then you're going to need something that's going to hold that in there really good. Because right now, there's nothing, it can pull out easily because there's nothing really holding it. So what I did with the other one was, you see here, I put this little flower, which is the daisy cutter. I use the daisy cutter in two sizes. I think the daisy cutter comes in four sizes. So I used a bigger one and then a smaller one in the center, and then I put a little round dot for that. But for the heart, let's go with the heart. So here's a heart, and here's the rest of my scrap clay. At this point, you don't want to add any powdered pigments or anything, because a little tip about powdered pigments, once you put powdered pigments onto polymer clay, it will stop the clay from sticking to it. So you don't want to do that. You don't want your clay not sticking because you want to add pieces on there. So let me put this heart on here. I'm just going to cut it out simply. And I'm not going to texture that. And I'm going to lay it where I want to put it right here. And then I would put my poker back in. So now I've actually added a little extra security for it at this point. I could have even done a little smaller one in the middle. So really, the sky's the limit. It's completely up to you what you want to do. So how cute is that? I mean, how cute is that? Can you imagine that sitting on a table at a wedding, you know, and we haven't even finished it or made it really super cute. So I have some other little hearts that I cut out. I could go around the sides with them and maybe back them together. That would be really cute. See how I've got them? You could texture them. And you could just create a design any way you want, going all the way around. So I think I went with a number 4 setting on this because I didn't want them to be thick. And you would just continue all around, poke out your little hearts, and then add them all the way around. Actually, this one's backwards to get it in the same. Actually, let me start over here. What I like to do is kind of start at each end and do the same. So they end up kind of at the same place. I don't know if you know what I mean, but like when I get down here, I kind of want the hearts to be going the right way as that they should. So I start and I get both sides done, and there you have it. So I would continue to go all the way around, which you can do. And actually, see, this is pulling out a little because I'm playing with it. So you might have to go back and fix it and maybe add a little dot in the middle. You could also bend your wire. You could take some pliers and bend it and then insert it, because that will help it to stay better. But I didn't feel like I needed it. It's not coming out of this one, you know, it's in there pretty good. So, although with this one, I might need to. So there you have that. Let's add a little decoration to it. Here's some powdered pigments. and I could just come back and simply rub it over the design. Once I have all my pieces added on there that I want, I can then add the powder pigments. You don't want to do it, like I said, before you get all your pieces added on, because powder pigments will stop the clay from sticking to itself. And you don't want that, because if I didn't add these on here and I put the powder pigments, the powder pigments would want to pull away. So do all your designing first, then add your powder pigments or your ink or whatever it is that you want to do. So there you have it. That's very simple to do. Easy to create, only takes a few minutes. And I wanted to show you something else that I made too with these little cookie cutter, with these little cutters. This is a little box. It hasn't been fired yet, so let me, powder pigments all over my hands. It hasn't been fired, so I'm knocking them off here. But anyways, it's a box, you get the gist. And this here is a henna design. And we carry the henna mold in the shop. Let me show you that. This is the henna mold. And I created this with the henna mold, and then I added some pan pastels to it to highlight it and bring out the color. These are the pan pastels. Obviously, they come in a little pan. And I just took the pan pastels, rubbed it on until I got the look I wanted. And then I took these oval cutters, and the oval cutters, I believe, come four to a set. So I used this oval cutter. And simply rolled out a flat sheet of clay, cut out a bunch, laid them out. And then I came back with my stylus tool. That's what this is called. I call it a poker sometimes, but it's a stylus tool. And then I just put the little holes going around here and then added them to there. I still have to fire them. I wasn't sure. I may add a little more color to them. I'm not sure if I'm 100% happy with the purple in there. But we'll see what happens. So simple and easy to do. Just cut out your design. I mean, we have eight sets of these cutters, and they're the plunger cutters, and there's seven different designs and sizes per set. So there's four sets with seven designs. So you can check those out at polymerclaytv.com and think about making different things with it. I mean, this is a really, really cute idea for a wedding, but you know, it can make a really nice gift if someone's having, like my sister just had her 50th birthday, and I could have personalized it and added a photo from when she was a kid or whatever. So you can think about different ways to use this technique and make it your own. You could even make the base a flower shape, a diamond shape, whatever you want. That's the beauty of it. It's a simple project, and you can just customize it to your own thing. So I hope you enjoyed this, and I'd love to see any photos that you have of anything you make that we, you know, or that we share on the show, or anything you make on your own. Head over to craftylink.ning.com and share those photos. We'd love to see them. Don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss a thing. We have a new demo every Wednesday that we share with you, and I hope to see you next time. So have an awesome, creative day.